Hi people, welcome to this video. We will discover what is and how to use CaptureOne Pro 8 very easily. Leave us comments to improve us. CaptureOne is a great software to manage and edit photos. We will see almost important features to be able to do everything with your photos. The workspace is composed by different parts. On top you have several quick buttons. On the left, different panels where you will apply adjustments and corrections. On the center, the media opened in preview. And at the bottom, the collection of all your imported files. In CaptureOne, you can import photos and videos only. To import, just click on Import Images, the first icon on top. Select the folder you want to open and all its media inside will appear on your screen. Select all files you want to import and then go to Import below. Remember that you can select more files holding Ctrl down. Every time you import images, a session is created. A session is a collection of imported images. This corresponds to a folder that is saved inside the system folder selected when you click on Import Images. Before importing, always select the right system folder before going on. If you imported more than once, you may have more sessions on the left. You can join all media files simply dragging these on your main session. If you right-click on a session and go to Show in Explorer, you will see its folder related. If you rename this folder, you do rename the session as well. You can check your sessions inside the Library panel on the left. To delete sessions, you must delete the folder from the Explorer. The minus simply deletes the session from the list, but not its folder. You can select which file to open and edit, selecting it at the bottom. CaptureOne lets you import videos, but you can't modify them at all. Select an image. You can check it better, zooming in and out using your mouse wheel. If you hold space down, you enable the pen tool to move around. On top, the four numbers indicate the levels of the RGB colors. 0 means there is none of one color. 255, the maximum level. The second panel is called the Capture. In short, this section sets all metadata related to the camera that took the picture. What is important is what is on top. In exposure evaluation, you have a graph that explains how exposure goes for all the four colors, green, blue, red, and white. You can check better hovering the image on the preview. Below, the indicator shows the overall exposure level. It is good if it is close to zero. Let's see how to simply edit and improve your selected photo. First of all, you need to rotate and crop it. Open the composition panel. To rotate, use the rotate buttons in the top left corner, or use rotation and flip to be more precise. You can drag the bar or type the precise value. You can also flip the image here. To crop the photo, so to cut parts of the photo you don't want anymore, enable the crop tool on top and check its settings on the left. To crop, just click and drag. All highlighted inside will be saved. Second step is to enhance the colors of the photo. Open the color panel. On top you find the histogram. This graph is very important to understand how colors are distributed. All colors are shown and each has a different graph. What you have to keep in mind is that the left part of the histogram represents all colors that compose the darker parts of the photo, while on the right the lighter ones. The higher is a color graph, the more such color is concentrated on that level of lightness. Below, correct lightness with white balance and use tint in case colors are a little wrong. Then correct the amount of color, going to color balance. Hue sets the color to place, while saturation the amount. You can also click on the circle. You can use black and white to make your photo black and white. Enable the effect and adjust the lightness of each single color that was present on the original photo. If the final aspect of the photo is not satisfactory, go to exposure. These tools make a stronger change on your image in terms of lightness, contrast and color amount. If you ever mistake, remember to press Ctrl and Z to undo. Third step is to enhance the photo, for example reducing its smoothness or correcting some precise parts. To reduce smoothness, you can use clarity inside the exposure panel. If you need more, you can go to details panel. Here you reduce smoothness, noise, or add effects like the film grain. Plus, if you go to lens on top, you can adjust the curvature applied on your photo or adding any vignetting effect. You can also stretch the image according to a defined perspective. Try the keystone tools out. What if you need to correct just some parts of the image? If you need to remove spots on the image, just go to details panel and then to spot removal at the bottom. Click on remove spot on the left or on top and include the spot to remove inside the circle. If you want to apply exposure, lightness and color just on parts of the photo, you need to create a drawing mask first. A mask is simply a selected part of the photo. Enable draw mask on top and click and drag to define it. To check your mask better, right-click on the button and check Always Display Mask. Right-click to change radius and settings. Hold Shift down and drag to move your mask. If you mistake at drawing the mask, you can right-click on Draw Mask on top and choose Erase Mask. When the mask is ready, you must open local adjustments on the left and then apply the adjustments. These are the same ones met before, with the difference that these will work just on the selected mask. Each mask is a defined layer in the list above. As long as you go on drawing on the same layer, you will expand your current mask instead of creating a new one. To create a new layer, so a mask with different adjustments applied in the future, just click on the plus at the bottom. In this way, you will define another new mask by drawing. Mind that the adjustments that you apply always affect the current selected layer or mask. Selected masks are always in red color on the workspace. The order of the layers can be important too. This can change the final effect of all adjustments. To change this order, just drag the layers up or down. In case your photo is okay, you just need to save it. As long as you keep it in your session, Even with everything applied, all changes are not yet saved on the photo. To apply all definitely, you must export the photo. Simply right-click on the photo selected and go to Export. You can choose between originals and variants. The first one saves the image as it was originally. The second one with all adjustments applied. In Export location, click on the gear to browse your favorite folder. In Export naming, inside Format, choose the name of your file. In Export receipt, you adjust all saving settings, like the file format, the coding and the resolution. Then go to Export below. Very important in CaptureOne are the variants related to a picture. A variant is simply the photo with some adjustments on it. You can associate more variants to a single photo, and each of them can have different adjustments applied. If you right-click on a photo and go to New Variant, you will have a copy of the original photo, on which you can apply adjustments different from your previous variant. If you use Clone Variant instead, you will start from the adjustments applied on the primary variant. To delete variants, just right-click and go to Delete. If you want to make comparisons, simply right-click on the variant to take as sample and go to Set as Compare Variant. Then simply select other variants to check them. Right-click again to finish with the comparisons. This is all. Check out our YouTube channel for more video tutorials.